Sorry, Mr. Caldwell. Bit early for me.
Yes. Your idea, boy, not mine.
No, I suggested after hours.
You'd leave them here?
Well hidden behind the tackle.
Well, I'd say there's no room for more. It's far too open as it is.
But I'm the gaffer here, Mr. Caldwell. Who's asking questions? And my friends are very pleased up to now. They think you're just a man. And what did I tell them, Mr. Caldwell?
I'm thinking about it.
Yeah, I know, but they were hoping that by this time...
Were they?
Well, there are other yards.
Don't you push me, boy. When's the next lot due?
Not this week.
Good.
But they don't tell me everything. Safer that way.
I see. I'm going away for a couple of days. I want a bit of peace. And get that car out of the way. I want to drive out.
Excuse me, madam.
Mm-hmm.
The breeches have arrived for Mr. Caldwell.
Oh, thank you, sir. Can you take them out to the guest room?
Certainly, madam.
Oh, no, hang on.
Sorry?
Bring them in here.
Very good, madam.
Let's have a look at them. Oh, yes. Oh, I like this. Let me just hold them up against you, Sutton, because you're about dad's size, aren't you? Oh, yes, I mean, they really are rather nice, and they suit you. Do you ride?
Not if I can help it, madam. I was just wondering about the hat and crop.
Oh, there are plenty in the stables.
Very good, madam.
Oh, and Sutton!
Yes, madam?
I've got a terrible shot for you.
Madam?
For the whole of next week, you're going to have to concentrate on good, plain cooking.
It's an elm tree, isn't it?
Well, it used to be an elm. The whole point is, it's right outside my cottage. I mean, it only needs a gale one night.
All right, I'll have a word with the forester.
I wish you would, my dear.
Stay for tea?
Yes, please.
But don't look so gloomy, Sutton. Your cordon bleu will rise again phoenix-like.
From the ashes, as I recall, madam.
Yes, well, now, steak and kidney puddings, chops, grills, plenty of chips. And he likes his steaks well done.
Well done, madam.
Bianchi, if it'll soften the blow.
Oh, well, my dear.
Helen's come to tea.
Who likes his steaks, Bianchi?
My dad.
Oh, is he coming to stay?
Mm-hmm.
How delightful. When?
Tomorrow, for a week. You better come to dinner.
Oh, yes, I'd like that. Tomorrow night? Oh, did you want him to yourself?
Oh, Lord, no. The more the merrier. Sutton, how are you on hot pot?
Hot pot?
With or without oysters, madam.
Without?
Oh, the traditional recipe does call for oysters.
Well, I think he likes it the way his mother cooked it, but I suppose we can always surprise him.
Whose are those, Sutton?
I've hired them for Daddy. Wants to go riding.
Good God. Has he ever ridden before?
I'm not sure, but he wants to go, and I'm not stopping him.
No, it is extraordinary how people who don't ride always think that all they have to do is to get on a horse and give it orders. The horse doesn't think like that. Anyway, I shall enjoy watching.
Do you agree, John?
No. My one stipulation is that you join us, Lady Helen. Now, you must be a sport and come with us.
Where to?
Riding.
Dad, Helen is an expert horsewoman.
Oh, well, all the more reason. Give me confidence. Is it a bargain?
Well, of course it is. When? Tomorrow morning?
Good. Splendid.
As a matter of interest, Charlie, when were you last on a horse?
I'll tell you. It was 8 years ago in the south of Portugal, in the heat of the day. And I stayed on, too. So I've no fears, provided you take it easy, of course. Oh, thank you, Sutton.
My word, that dinner was a good one.
Oh, thank you, sir.
I don't suppose I could take him back with me, could I? Just for a week?
No, you can't. Anyway, what would Aunt Paul say?
Well, that's just it. She's going off to one of her socialist get-togethers and leaving me at the mercy of Edith.
Edith?
A Caldwell family heirloom.
Oh, Edith's not too bad on the basics, but I don't think she's ever seen an oyster. Let alone put one in a hot pot.
Well, Sutton, you feel like a change?
No! Oh, I'm so...
No, 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 I'm only joking, of course. I'll manage, I've no doubt. Any politicians among your ancestors, James?
No, not many, I'm afraid, but you never know. We might have a few in the future.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Actually, I was wondering about him.
Ah, that's Walter Hadleigh. James's
An uncanny resemblance, you know. I've noticed it in others about the house. A definite family likeness through the ages.
Well, a definite family nose through the ages.
Now, don't be disloyal, James.
I think it's a beautiful nose, and I'd never have married you if you hadn't inherited it.
Well, it's noticeable, certainly. Impressive, perhaps, but beautiful, no. Hmm.
A lot of soldiers in your family, I noticed, mixed up with a few clergymen.
Yes.
There was a pirate once, if you go back far enough.
A pirate now? That's more my stamp.
He didn't have his portrait painted, for obvious reasons.
Ah, well, they never made me walk the plank, but I was at sea myself once, you know.
Were you?
Yes, in the Navy, all through the war, the finest service in the world.
Destroyers, wasn't it, Charlie?
Yes, to start with. Long-distance convoys. That's what did the trick, you know, when you look back. Supplies. Having the right men and the right materials in the right place at the right time.
I'm sure that must have been terribly important.
I've said it before, and I'll say it again. The Second World War was won by the British Navy. Have I said something to offend?
It's just that Melford has a military tradition, you see.
No offence intended, Lady Helen.
And none taken, Mr. Caldwell.
Charlie, Lady Helen.
Charlie. Well, it's getting late. I must be going. Good night, Jennifer, my dear.
Good night.
I have enjoyed myself.
Good.
Good night, Mr. Charlie.
Good night, Lady Helen. And you haven't forgotten the writing. You won't go back on it now, will you?
No, of course I won't. What time, James?
Oh, not too early, James.
12 o'clock. How's that?
I'll be there.
I'll drive you home. Sutton, Lady Helen is leaving. Would you get her coat?
Certainly.
Thank you. Did you really enjoy yourself?
Yes, I did, as a matter of fact.
Good.
Strange as it may seem.
Thank you, sir.
It does rather hold the floor, doesn't it? Thank you, my dear. Good night, Sutton.
Good night, my lady.
Thank you.
Charming woman, Lady Helen. Charming.
Yes. More brandy?
No, no, thank you. Quite enough. Oh. It's good to see you.
You too.
You're happy, I can see that.
Yes, I am very happy. And you?
Oh, I'm all right.
You look a bit tired.
Well, you know me, can't sit still. Never could. Always having to prove I was as good a man today as I was yesterday, even if I am 24 hours older. That's something I envy about your husband.
What?
Well, his relaxation, his inner certainty, a sort of being at peace with himself. Comes with breeding, I suppose.
You're a no snob. Aren't you at peace with yourself?
Oh, when I managed to get to Wales now and again, where I was a boy. But not in London or Liverpool or any of the other places I do business. But this is good. Here. Just what the doctor ordered.
Doctor?
Oh, touch of blood pressure, nothing serious.
Dad?
Promise you.
Okay. Come on. It's bedtime.
Quite right.
Oh.
What your grandmother would say if she could see you now. Her with her two up, two down.
And the privy down the path.
Well, now, don't you get too complacent. The plumbing here hasn't changed much in 200 years.
Do for Charlie, don't you? At least it's up to wait, isn't it? Where the hell is he? Do you know?
Thank you. I think he's a bit shy. I'll go get him out of hiding.
There you go.
Come out, Dad, wherever you are.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Excuse me, sir. You'll be needing these.
Thank you, Mrs. Brennan.
Try it on, sir. Go on.
Shall I?
Go on. Oh, it suits you perfectly, sir.
You're having me on.
Oh, no, I wouldn't. It does.
Hey, Dad! Oh, that's fantastic. Oh, that really is. That's great.
Morning, Charlotte. There you are.
This one?
Yes. Just about your size, I think, wouldn't you?
Oh, it's very docile, I promise you, Dad.
Doped, I hope. Well, when in Rome.
Got a leg up.
Yes, well, one. All right. I seem to be.
There you are.
Well, what's her name?
It's him, actually. Shelley.
Oh. Hello, Shelley!
Melford Park. Who's that, please? No, I'm afraid he's not here. Can I take a message? Oh, I see. Well, if you'll hold on, I'll see if I can reach him. And who is speak... Yes, I'll try not to be too long.
Yes,
me.
You have. You're late as usual, you know.
I've got the
hand of hawthorn. Excuse me, Mr. Caldwell. There's a telephone call for you in the library.
Me?
Yes, sir. The caller said it was urgent.
Oh. Hang on to this.
You've gone white, sir.
John?
Caldwell, what do you want? Yeah, but can't you deal with it? Yeah, but surely you don't need me. No. No, well... All right, if you insist. When? Immediately? Oh, all right. Oh, sorry to spoil the fun, Pet. I've got to go back.
What, now? This minute?
Yes, business urgent, I'm afraid.
Oh, no.
Help me pack, will you, Sutton, and bring my car around the front?
Oh, very good, sir.
Help.
Goodbye, Lady Helen, and my apologies.
Must you really go? You can launch massive business enterprises from here, you know.
Yes, I know, but this needs my personal attention, I'm afraid. Goodbye, James.
Goodbye, Charlie.
Well, mind you come coming. Back again soon.
As soon as I possibly can.
Coming with you.
Since when?
Since now, I've just decided.
Well, snap decisions seem to run in the family.
Well, it won't be for long, and you'll manage.
But there's no need. I can manage, too.
Alone with Edith.
Oh, don't be silly.
Look, my case is in the car, and I'm coming, and that's flat.
Now, what do I do, James? You stop her.
Well, if she's made up her mind,
I'm out,
Charlie.
So that's that. Bye-bye, Helen.
Well, goodbye, my dear.
Come on. Come on. I think something's wrong, okay?
Goodbye, James.
Bye.
Thanks for everything. I'll send her back.
Hole, if you please.
Yes.
I'll phone.
To get out of the riding.
Your guess is as good as mine, Ella.
Most odd. Well, I'd better be getting home.
Oh, I am sorry. Look, why don't you stay for lunch?
No, thanks. That hot pot last night will last me quite a while.
What is for lunch, son?
Steak and kidney pudding, sir.
Oh, my God.
Good luck, James.
I'm sorry. A shipmaid? Look, I'm sorry, I really... Now, what do you mean? What sort of trouble? Well, in that case, I really see no point in your phoning me. What do you mean? Can you prove this? Yes, but have you got any proof? Piper's Yard. Yes, I've got that. Piper. Look, who is this speaking, please?
Yes, sir.
Sutton, I've got to go to Liverpool. Would you pack a bag for me, please?
Certainly, sir. Will you be leaving right away?
Yeah. No, I shall go first thing in the morning.
And staying with Mr. Caldwell, sir?
Yes. Yes, of course I will. But don't tell them, will you, Sutton? Just leave that to me.
Very good, sir.
Thank you. You can't park there. Not there, mate. What did you want, anyway?
Well, I was looking for the works manager. Is that you?
No, it's Mr. Unwin you want. Office over there through the loading bay. And you still can't park there.
Someone's allowed to.
Mr. Unwin's office is up there.
Oh, thank you.
Mr. Unwin?
Yeah?
James Hadleigh. I'm Charlie Caldwell's son-in-law.
Sit down.
Is Charlie here today?
Yeah, not expected. And I don't think...
No. I was just passing through. So I thought I'd take a look at the place. He's often told me about it.
Oh.
It's much smaller than I thought.
Well, it would be. It's the first place he bought, you know, back in 1946.
Yes, he did tell me that.
He keeps it for sentimental reasons.
Do you smoke?
Aye, but not them things. Black shag.
I see. You knew Charlie in the old days, did you?
Yes, we were in the Navy together. Torpedoed on the way to Murmansk.
Really? You never told me that. Thank you.
I remember he mustered. We decided to take the diving course, you know. Not going to stay able to see him in all our lives. And then it was my disposal, salvaging wrecks.
You kept in touch ever since, did you?
Even after I was invalided out.
But I thought that Charlie went back to Cardiff when he was demobbed.
Yes, but not for long. He'd lost his father and two brothers in the Blitz there.
Yeah.
And he had his mother and kid sister dependent on him, so, you know, he could see it was preying on his mother's mind, all she'd been through. So Charlie just upped and moved a lot of them here to Liverpool, and I joined him on his first job. Marine salvaging.
He never looked back, did he?
That's Charlie. Before he could turn around, he decided to go it on his own. Blue Dodge gratuity, 200 quid and bought his first tugboat. That's her there, the Misty Lou.
And you were partners in those days, were you?
Yes, in a manner of speaking. There was never anything in writing. But once Charlie really got going, I was glad to take a back seat.
How was that?
Well, Charlie's got the brains and the drive. Me, I'm just a bit of a stick in the mud, you know. One desk is all I want.
And Charlie agreed to that?
Besides, it was all his own capital. I never looked to it, we lived together.
Well, money's not the only form of investment, is it?
Well, I just provided the early contacts. He did the rest on his own steam. Nowadays, it's a word of advice here, a word of caution there.
Well, that's my point, really, isn't it?
Well, I'm not complaining, Mr. Hadleigh, and I'll tell you this. I'll never want while Charlie's up on top.
Shipmate? Does he ever come here, Charlie?
He's a busy man.
Sign here, please, Mr. Unwin.
Brady, my foreman.
One of Charlie's appointments, is he?
No, mine. He came for the job.
He's a bright-looking lad, isn't he, for a small organisation like this?
Yes, well, if it's Charlie you want, Mr. Hadleigh, his main office is down in the town. I feel sure you'll find him there.
Thank you, Mr. Hadleigh.
I'm coming as fast as as my legs will carry me.
Hello, Edith.
Oh, good afternoon, sir.
Is my wife at home, Mrs. Hadleigh?
Oh, Mr. Hadleigh.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm ever so sorry. It's my eyes, you see. Well, I keep telling myself I should get glasses, especially since I get the migraine.
Edith, you don't happen to know where the...
Hello, darling. You look busy.
What are you doing here?
Well, I'm just passing through Liverpool by an odd coincidence.
Really?
Yes, Keith Rixit phoned. He asked me to go to the animal health conference with him at Lytham tomorrow.
Oh, heavens, on earth didn't you phone?
I thought I'd surprise you. Aren't I welcome?
Oh, of course. Oh, Dad's fine. Everything's okay.
Good, good.
If that's what you were worried about.
Not really, no. Well, I can always go on to Lytham.
Oh, no. It just is such an odd coincidence.
Well, Charlie didn't think so. I've just phoned him. And you've got a smart on the Caldwell nose. Here.
Oh, hello, Edith.
Good evening, sir.
Where's Jennifer?
Oh, Miss Jennifer's upstairs having a bath and... Mr. Hadley's in there.
Oh. Delighted to see you, James. Absolutely delighted. Where are you on your way to?
Lytham, the animal health conference.
Ah, yes. But you're staying here tonight, aren't you?
Well, if I may, yes.
Of course you may, my boy. Of course you may. I wish you had more time to stay longer. Let me show you round. Last time you were here. That confounded wedding, eh? No comment. I'd like to give you a grand tour of inspection.
Well, I'm free tomorrow morning, Charlie.
Are you? Well, yes, I think I am too, all right. Where would you like to start?
At the beginning?
Finally in here for dispatch at the end of the day.
Morning, Mr. Caldwell.
Hello, lad. Only small stuff, mind you. It's a folly keeping the place going at all.
Yeah.
But stuff still goes out from this department to all four corners of the world.
What are these, Charlie?
Oh, machine tools. Germany, I should think. They take a lot of our industrial stuff.
Do they?
Brady?
He's just popped out a minute, sir.
Where to?
Cigarettes, I think.
I see. And then, over here, come and look. Direct access to the dockside.
Amazing what you pick up in the salvage business, isn't it, Charlie?
Well, all sorts of keep your eyes open.
Why don't you sell these on the home market? I mean, why do you bother with export duties, all that sort of thing?
Well, they go where the price is right. Tell Brady I want him in the office the minute he gets back.
Right, sir.
Come on, son. Hello, Walter.
Hello, Charlie.
This is my son-in-law, James Hadleigh, Walter Unwin. Wanted to see where it all began, didn't you? Well, there's my first tugboat, the Misty Lou. Everything all right, Walter?
Fine, Charlie. Mm.
Yes, Mr. Caldwell.
Well, there's a consignment of machine tools in the loading bay. Should have been cleared, shouldn't they?
I'll look into it, sir. Is that all?
Yes, for the moment.
Hello.
You know him?
I never met him, Charlie.
He's a copy. Well, we'll leave you in peace, Walter. There are a few more places we want to see before you leave for Lytham, is it, James?
Yes, that's right, Lytham. Bye, Mr. Unwin. It's been nice meeting you.
Will Mr. Hadleigh be in for supper this evening?
No, he's spending the night in Lytham, but he'll be back tomorrow.
Oh, good.
Ah, Edith. I'd like to cook for them myself tomorrow, so you take the evening off.
Oh. Well, your father likes a bit of potted meat sometimes, on toast. If you were thinking of something for him.
Yes, but, I don't think Mr. Hadleigh,
Oh, dear, someone at the door.
Good evening.
Good evening, sir.
Is Charlie Colvin at home?
No, not yet, but we're expecting him back quite soon.
I'm his daughter. Can I help you?
Oh, no, thanks. I'll wait.
Leaving?
Well, the concert's on tonight, you know, the Philharmonic, and I promised the eldest girl that.
Yes, well, we've got to have a talk first, haven't we?
You know, I thought it was probably you who phoned when you didn't tell Charlie this morning that we'd met. I was absolutely sure.
Yes, well, Charlie spoke about you and I had an idea of you, so I just took a chance.
I'm very glad you did. That's if Charlie is in trouble.
Yeah, well, I've no idea what he's up to, and that's a fact, but something's going on. I've known for weeks. Something that doesn't become him or this firm.
Such as what?
I can't pin it down. Folk are too fly for me.
Is it contraband?
I may be.
Well, he's on the river, isn't he? I mean, he's got all the right shipping connections.
Not just the sea, Mr. Hadleigh. That's too risky. Cars. Holidaymakers parked down by the gates. And other vehicles. A delivery van, an ambulance, a school bus once. There's no reasons for them.
Who's the middleman then, Brady?
Smart young chap for a small organisation.
You told Charlie about this. He could be ignorant of that.
I tried to talk. He shut up like a clam. He told me to keep my nose clean.
Listen, there are other things you could do. Other steps, aren't there?
Not at my age. I've worked. I'm a few years off retirement. Look, that's me, isn't it? A few years off retirement. I've worked hard all my life and I've got nothing to show. I can pay for my bed and my medical bills. Yeah. I cross Charlie now. I'll be out my ear tomorrow. Yes, with nothing to show.
If he gets found out. Now, where will you be then?
Well, Charlie, look after that.
Like he did before, you mean?
Look, I'm still in work after all the illness. Now, that counts for something.
There are some packing cases. Down there in the loading bay, I've seen them. They're machine tools, they're Charlie's labels, and they're marked for Glasgow, not Germany, as Charlie claimed.
Yeah.
Well, I've just checked on the Glasgow firm in a trade directory. It doesn't exist.
Well, that's Charlie's business. Don't ask me.
I'm not asking you, but I really want to know what's in those cases if it's not machine tools. Now, have you got any ideas?
I haven't a clue.
Because that's a fact. It very badly needs some proof.
Thank you, Edith.
Gets a bit parky now the nights are drawing in.
Yes, it does.
Having a rare old confab in the study, your father and that man. When I went in, they were huddled together over some papers.
Who is he, do you know?
Oh, don't ask me. But I don't like the look of him much, do you?
No, not a lot.
Somebody from the works, I expect. He was here last week, you know, asking for Mr. Caldwell while he was away.
Oh, did he say what he wanted?
Oh, not to me. But it was urgent. That's why I gave him your telephone number over in Yorkshire so he could... Well, I hope I did right.
Oh, yes.
Oh, God. Well, good night, Miss Jennifer.
Good night, Edith. Sleep well. Thank you.
My friends are very pleased with your decision, Mr. Caldwell. I was specially asked to tell you.
But if we're going to expand, there's got to be some changes here. I don't want the stuff lying open for all the world to see.
That fellow yesterday.
That gentleman happened to be my son-in-law. He had no special interest, but he saw them, Brady. So I'll need to talk to somebody higher up, make certain it's watertight. So you fix a meeting soon, and I don't come to them, they come to me.
They are used to making the arrangements, Mr. Caldwell.
If they're buying, I'm not. They need facilities on a big scale. I can provide them, so I make the terms now. And I deal directly with the top.
I don't even know who they are. Only the next man up.
Well, tell him. That's the only way I do business.
Your son-in-law, Mr. Caldwell.
What about him? What about him?
He was here the day before.
Were all the animals well?
Hmm? Ah, the conference. Yes. You see, we're blooming with health. What have you been up to?
Nothing much. Actually, I've been sitting here wondering if I could ever persuade Dad to change this furniture, because it really is hideous.
Are you expecting him back tonight?
Yes, he's due any minute, actually. I've given Edith the evening off, and I have cooked for you a filet de bœuf en croûte.
Sutton style?
My style. Dad had a visitor. Very mysterious.
Would it be anyone you know?
No, and I wasn't allowed to be introduced.
Not allowed?
No. Edith let him in, and he said he wanted to wait for Dad. I asked him his name and he wouldn't give it. And when Dad came in, he just whisked him off into the study.
Well, what did he look like? Do you know?
Ordinary. Didn't see much of his face because he never took his hat off.
His voice?
Irish, sort of, but well educated. And Edith said he was here last week asking for our telephone number in Melford, so...
Hello, Charlie.
I'll leave us, Jennifer, for a while. I want a private word with James. Oh, very well. Stay if you must, but don't blame me for what you'll hear. Your animal health, too. It went well, did it?
Quite well, Charlie.
Remarkable, since it never even took place.
What?
I checked, you see. It comes to a pretty pass when members of your own family have to resort to checking up on each other.
Well, I'm very glad you found me out, Charlie, because now at last, perhaps, we can be straight with each other.
Well, I'm all for that, boy, so perhaps you'll start by telling me why you came to Liverpool, snooped in at Piper's Yard.
No, I was not snooping. I came by invitation.
Invitation? What do you mean? Whose invitation? Look, Edith will get that.
She's out.
Then I'll get it. I've got a few things to settle with this gentleman. Could take a couple of hours. No, no, not here. I know a quiet little pub where people mind their own business.
Is that mysterious?
Yes. Now, would you mind telling me what the hell's going on?
Look. I had a phone call at Melford from somebody who told me that your father is in trouble.
Who?
Well, it doesn't really matter who, does it? I mean, I had to come over here and I had to find out whether he was telling the truth or not. Now, I'm not very proud of my man.
No, you shouldn't be either, should you, snooping round his works behind his back and poking your nose into things that just don't concern
you? It does concern me. It concerns all of us. We're one family, aren't we? I don't want your father to get into trouble any more than you do.
And did you find anything?
Yes, I did. I opened a packing case that was marked machine tools. It was stacked with guns and ammunition.
Well, how do you know that that wasn't all perfectly above board?
Because your father proved it wasn't by lying and evasion. He knew perfectly well what was in those cases. He tried to fob me off with a cock and bull story about machine tools going to jail. I saw the labels. They were absolutely phony.
Look, do you know what you're saying about my own father?
Yes, I do, and I'm very sorry.
You think he needs money, that kind of money?
He's a devious man, Jenny. He loves a gamble.
He's my father!
Look, all I'm saying is there's something fishy going on. Your father's involved in it, and it just could be dangerous.
So what are you going to do about it? Go to the police?
Oh, please, don't be silly.
Listen, I won't believe it. But of course, if you feel so strongly about it, then you must go to the police, mustn't you?
You're angry only because I didn't tell you, aren't you? Well, I couldn't. Not until I was sure it was true. So it's no good shouting at me. We've got to decide what we're going to do.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Well, I'll talk to him tonight when he comes back.
No, not tonight, because I'd like to sleep on it. I need time to think.
You call me a crook, and all I ask is
They've been going at it for an hour. I'm trying to give them breakfast.
What the hell
did you... Dad!
You're not a high and mighty Melford now, you
We're
know.
We're trying to help you.
Help me?
Yes, help.
Look, do me a favour, will you, in future? Keep out of my affairs.
Listen, if you go on like this, you know...
Well?
We'll just have to draw our own conclusions.
Will you do that and drop me a postcard?
Oh, Mr. Pig-headed Charlie, do you realise what a spot this puts us in?
Well, it's your own fault breaking into my premises like a common thief.
Look, I came at
the invitation of your works manager, Charlie.
Walter?
He phoned me at Melford, yes. He used to be your partner. He phoned me. He was worried.
Well, there's a reward for loyalty.
He did it for you, Charlie. He's on your side.
He did it for me. He did it for himself. It's his yard.
And who'll carry the can?
Look, I could have you up, you know that. Put you behind bars.
I very much doubt it, Charlie. But if that's how you feel about it, well, why don't you just try?
Well, I've got more to do with my time.
Dad, look, just tell us the truth.
Have I ever let you down? Ever in all your life?
No.
Well, then.
Not that I know of.
That's no answer.
It's the only answer I can give you under the circumstances.
Well, that's it, then.
Charlie, please.
Look, I'm going to work, and I don't want to see either of you here when I get back. Yeah, we've been fouled up good and proper. You get over here right away. I don't give a damn who sees you.
Come on, Charlie.
I've got a bone to pick with you.
Good.
Sit down.
You're sure this is what you want, eh? To run away?
What else? How would you feel?
Well, it's your home.
Mm-mm. It used to be.
Hello. Yes, that's right. Yes, she is. She's right here. Yes, all right. We'll come right away.
Well, who was it?
It was the dock police. They want to see us right away at CID.
Mr. Hadleigh?
Yes. I'm Detective Inspector Shaughnessy. Good of you to come.
James, it's him.
What's that? Who?
Mysterioso.
Yes, well, this kind of thing's been going on all the time, and we've got to stop it. Packing cases like that are smuggled in as part of general bulk cargo, picked up by members of the organization and taken to small and obtrusive distribution points like Piper's Yard, which have already been infiltrated by young fellow members like Brady. Now, he sees to it that they're broken up into smaller parcels for individual transport over the pond and other places, usually in private cars.
And, of course, you can't search every vehicle that comes off a car ferry, or every holidaymaker come to that.
So we take a leaf out of their book and infiltrate.
Well, crack it from the inside, innit?
That's where Dad comes in.
Yes, your father's been helping us with our inquiries. And for once, that means exactly what it says.
You're not the only inquisitive member of the family, James. And when I see the foreman in a dispatch department running a new expensive car, I want to know the reason why.
Brady, you mean?
Yeah. So I make it known to him I'm interested, and the rest follows easily, but I make sure these gentlemen know first.
Now, it's only been small fry up to the moment. But thanks to Charlie's bargaining powers, we're playing a big fish now.
The top man in the Northwest.
A meeting's been arranged for next week. Hence all the cloak and dagger stuff. Visits after dark and so on. I'm sorry if I seemed entirely devoid of manners.
I was under strict orders not to tell anybody.
Now, these fellows are playing for big stakes. They miss nothing. Excuse me. Detective Inspector Shaughnessy? Mr. Colwell. Pity. Thank you. That was your works manager.
Well, I had to let Walter in on it when things got to this pitch.
Brady's done a bunk in that smart car of his. I must have been seen when I heard round this morning.
Well, that's it. My fault.
No, no, no. It was ours.
I am sorry. I do apologise to both of you.
Never mind. We'll catch up with him. Besides, we've one of two other irons in the fire you have to have in this business.
Devious, James. You know what I mean?
Look, I really am very sorry.
Shaughnessy, what is it?
Dad, why didn't you ask me to trust you earlier?
Did I need to ask you, Jen?
Oh, Dad.
All right, don't say it. I know.
I'll attend to it. Mr. Hadleigh.
Yes.
I know you arrived in rather a hurry, sir, but would you mind moving your car? Apparently you're on the chief superintendent's patch.
All right, thank you, sir. Anything else?
Lady Helen telephoned, sir, about the elm. There was a strong wind last night, and she's rather concerned about the safety of the car.
Yes, all right. I'll talk to the forester in the morning.
Apart from that, nothing, sir.
Fine, thank you. Good night.
Good night. Good night, Mrs. Hadleigh.
Night, sir.
All right, come on. What's on your mind?
I'm trying to understand why Dad was so willing to cooperate with the police, because it's never been known before.
Mm.
Do you think they were leaning on him?
Yes, I should think so. Just a little bit.
What sort of deal?
Hmm. They'd turn a blind eye in certain quarters in return for help when they need it.
Hmm. Do you think that Dad,
bends the law a bit? Yes, yes, I should think he does. You have to, you see, when you're in Charlie's shoes.
Well, would you do the same thing?
Me? Well, in Charlie's shoes, yes, I think I might.
Thank God for that.